Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Goffstown High School Girls Basketball. My name is Al DeRusso. I'll be announcing tonight's game, and along with Caleb Brown, who's going to do our color commentating for us.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Goffstown High School. It should be a fun one as Goffstown trying to ride up their new momentum after winning three in a row against Kennett, Pembroke, and Plymouth with a record of 3-2 on the year. Oyster River is going to be coming in with a record of 2-3. So this should be a fun one for tonight, Al.
Yeah, it should be a good matchup. They seem, height-wise, they seem to be about equal, so it'll be interesting to see how they play.
It'll be interesting, too, because Goffstown is starting both their freshmen, Welsh and Brennan, so it should definitely be interesting to see how they're going to perform tonight against a team with a similar record.
I had a feeling when I first saw the first two games that they were doing a lot of experimenting, so it looks like they seem to have found a group here to work. So we get the tap off, and it's controlled by Oyster River. And sent up the sideline and thrown out of bounds. It'll be Goffstown's ball.
Goffstown going to try to set up a good possession here, but it looks like Oyster River's coming in with a full-court press.
Yep. Let's see how they look for the trap.
Oh, nice trap right there.
Yep. Stays here.
It's like Goffstown's going to try to find a way to bring a press break. Looks like they're running a – trying to run a pick to get Welsh
open.
Move
it up the sideline there in better shape. Okay, Brennan's got the ball out in the point. Looks like they set up in a man-to-man. In the corner with it is Perez.
It's like they're going to try to deny any open spots down low.
Yeah. It's all right. They're going to move the ball. They're moving around the outside. Brennan looking. Back to Perez. They're trying to look inside to Edmonds. Oh, Brennan's got it outside. She gets it inside. Nice drive to the basket.
Oh, good take.
Oh, nice play that time by Jessica Edmonds.
Good take. And she definitely used her size advantage to move inside. But it looks like Oyster River's on the break.
Whoa.
Just like that, game's tied again, and Oyster River's continuing with their full-court press.
They get it out on the side, down the roof. Hey, Brennan finds it underneath. Oh, nice play.
That was a good take by Edmonds, and she'll go to the free throw line.
Yeah, she was wide open. It was a good look by Brennan. Caught her right down underneath. Ooh. You're shooting.
It's like fouls on number 11, Sophie Broussard for Oyster River.
That's her first, team first. Wow, how did that not become a foul shot?
Yeah, I was really surprised because she looked like she went up with it.
Yeah, three-point shot from the outside for Goffstown, rebound underneath, fought for, and we've got a jump, and it should go to Goffstown.
And it will be. No, it's Oyster River ball.
Oyster River got the ball on the tap.
Huh.
Someone's not paying attention.
Well, looks like Goffstown's coming out with a playing man-to-man defense themselves. Good nice defense.
Nice job that time by Edmonds. Someone's got to pay a little more attention to the ball control.
Yep.
I don't understand how it didn't go to Goffstown, but. So Oyster River has got the ball.
Fumbled a little
bit. Goffstown's in a zone. Shot from the outside, no good. Fought for underneath, out of bounds against Oyster River. It'll be Goffstown ball. And again, we're facing the press. It's in, back to the middle. Nice job breaking that press.
Seems like Oyster River's running a full court man-to-man press instead of a usual zone press.
Yep. They go to the sides in the corner. Oh, nice drive to the hoop.
Oh, good take by Welsh.
Good rebound. Nice rebound. So Edmonds will go to the line for two this time.
Oh, looks like the clock's running. Notice the clock was running earlier on the inbound pass.
They looks like they may be breaking in a new person. Who is that that follows on, let's see, on Durant? That's her first. Team second.
Durant's one of their taller players, so she better be careful of the fouls because they might need that size later in the game.
Yep. Shooting two for Goffstown is Jessica Edmonds. First one's good.
Good shot.
And she'll get a second. And that one's good.
Goffstown man-to-man defense, full court press too.
Good pressure on the sideline. Oh, attempted steal.
Ball's loose.
Nice try. Oh, they got a foul on Goffstown. Looks like it's going to be on Edmonds.
Seems like a good call. She did run her over a little bit.
They got the name of that truck. Run you over. That's her first and the team's first. Outside shot. No good. Rebound fought for underneath. It goes out of bounds.
Oh.
It's going to be Goffstown ball.
Ref pointed the other way for a second, though, but yeah. Quickly changed his mind.
Pressure. Nice job. Back and forth. Look up court. So on the side, Perez looks inside for Brennan. Perez outside, gives it over to Walsh. Back to Perez. And again, they're giving and going and looking to see if they can create an opening. Back outside, knocked out of bounds by Oyster River.
Oyster River is kind of denying all ways to get the ball inside. They're definitely want to try to make Goffstown settle for outside jumpers.
Nice thing that Goffstown's doing is they're moving and pick. They're going against coming off of picks. So they're bound to get somebody open.
Yep, being very patient with the ball.
Nice job by Brennan. And we got a foul.
Good take by Brennan.
Fouls on 11. That's Broussard. That's her second. Team's third. Going to the line for two is going to be Brennan.
Looks like Maddie Chambers will be checking in for Oyster River.
First shot, no good. And she'll get her second. That one's good. We had a 5-2 Goffstown lead. Oyster River with the ball. Good drive to the hoop. Good save that time by Walsh.
And looks like it'll be...
It's going to stay. It'll be Oyster River's ball. Nice job. Great job. That
oh, good steal.
Oh, nice.
And good play. Good play by Edmonds.
And she's fouled in the backcourt. That foul's on Chambers. That's her first. Team's fourth. We got a substitute for Goffstown.
It's LaRochelle. Good shooter and a very good defensive player. Good take by Welsh.
Nice basket.
Nice play by the freshman.
Excellent. Nice drive to the hoop.
Oh, travel violation.
Good defense. Got a timeout, Oyster River. 30-second timeout. So Oyster River has picked up four fouls in the team fouls in the first quarter.
Yep, Goffstown only has one. The boys team for Goffstown did pretty good last night against Oyster River themselves. They won 48-42 in a close game.
Yeah. They're coming around as well. They're starting to find their players.
Yep, they won back-to-back games now. So definitely they figured things out in the holiday tournament, and they and Gasper definitely probably feels like they got a good good court now.
Yeah, a lot of times, a lot of teams don't like to participate in these holiday tournaments. They try to get a lot of practice time in, but, you know, when you get to see different players, different situations, it really helps to expand your team a bit.
Because in the tournament, they played two Division I teams. One of them was Nashua South, which is a very good team.
Yep.
And that definitely feels out what they'll probably play like when they go up against a bigger team.
Yep, definitely. Okay, Perez looking inside. Drives inside, gets it outside to Brennan. She tries to drive inside, nothing. Oh, nice pass, nice drive.
Good play by Welsh. Another good play by the freshman.
That's the second time now she's driven right to the basket. Oyster River trying to get it in. Get it over the timeline. Into the corner. Shot no good. Rebound underneath by Oyster River.
Good follow. Good
offensive by rebound. Lewis. And we have a foul.
Offensive foul.
It's on Walsh.
Nope, it's on LaRochelle.
LaRochelle. That's her first and team second.
It's like checking in for the Grizzlies is Kaylee Gagnon and Cameron Durham, two sophomores.
Ooh, that was close to travel on that one. Shot from the outside, Oyster River, no good. Rebound, fought for, picked up. Loose ball.
Ball's loose.
Good shot.
Good
rebound
play.
Right back to Oyster River. Rebound underneath, fought for. Picked up by Oyster River again. Shot outside, no good. Rebound that time, taken by Brennan. She pushes up the court quickly. Gets it over to Wall. Oh, nice pass,
nice pass.
Inside.
Oh, almost got the bounce.
Nice play. Nice give and go.
Yeah, a lot of shots by Oyster River. Seems that the ones that are missing are taking really high bounces back out right into their hands.
That foul's on Chambers. That's her second. LaRochelle makes her first shot. And we got a substitution for Oyster River.
Looks like it's Jackie Lipinski, senior.
Second shot's no good. Rebound taken by Oyster River. They'll bring it up. Oyster River has been very cold shooting outside. Oh! I think Brennan was hoping for the shot because she had it nailed if she did, but she went to the floor and she fouled her instead.
Good defense by her, though.
Yep, yep. Okay, Brennan with it. Outside the Gagnon. She's looking for some help. Loses control of the ball, gets it over to Walsh. Nice drive to the basket. No good. Rebound fought for underneath and picked up by Oyster River.
It seems like every time a shot goes up, all the Oyster River players collapse under the basket.
They have position, both offense and defense. Ball on the outside. They look in. Oh, and we've got a foul on Gagnon. That's their first and the team's fourth. Ball at the top of the key. Oh, nice pass underneath.
It's like they lost sight of her.
Yep. That was Lewis. That's her second basket of the night. Brennan with the ball in the corner. Gagnon. Walsh wants a setup. Oh, quick pass to the corner to Durham, and it went a little bit too strong and out of bounds, and it'll be Oyster River's ball. I 10-6, Goffstown leads. Ball on the outside shot, no good, rebound taken underneath by Durham.
That was a fourth shot, bad shot.
The 37 seconds and counting. Let's see if Goffstown plays for a last shot or just for the, if there's an opening, they're going to take it. Walsh, nice move, good drive to the basket, good block that time.
Yep, good defense, no foul there.
Taken, back with the ball at the top of the key. Oyster River.
Oh, little miscommunication right there.
Yep. Looking inside, fought for, and it goes out of bounds on Goffstown. It'll still be Oyster River's ball. 5.5 seconds left here in the first quarter. Ball's inbounded. Oh, nice steal by Brennan.
Nice steal.
But she had nowhere to go. She had Durant facing her right there at half court with about a 4-inch difference, and she wasn't going to get that long shot off. But we've got a score of 10-6 here at the end of the first quarter.
Both sides playing very good defense, making a low-scoring game so far.
Yeah, Goffstown's been very, very patient.
But that shows how they're starting to improve. They're not settling for, not getting lazy and settling for outside jumpers.
Well, he's got a lot of young players on the team too.
Yep.
So that means a lot.
Yep. Because last year, the team lost a lot of seniors, and especially a lot of size with players like Saban Pelletier, Hannah LaRochelle, Catherine Howe. But it'll definitely show how some players who were on JV last year will now have to step it up this year.
Well, they're getting the opportunity, and you get freshmen starting on varsity. That's a good sign.
And two of them in the starting lineup, so Walsh and Brennan, those two will be a very good combo for their high school career.
It's a good start for them.
Yeah. It's never a bad idea to start a couple freshmen or have a couple on varsity.
Definitely. So Goffstown comes out. Minnick is in the game for the first time.
Another sophomore. And looks like Sierra Gilmore, a senior, will be checking in too.
We start the second quarter. On the point, running the point is Minnick. In the corner. Good defense on Oyster River's part. I think what Goffstown's looking for is the first person that's going to make the mistake. It'll take a three-point shot, no good. Rebound fought for, picked up by Oyster River. Oh, I thought that was a double. Ball underneath, back outside, drive the baseline. Kick it back out. Rebound this time fought for and picked up by Goffstown.
Good ball movement. And Gagnon hits the deck. And they all hit the deck. We got people flying all over the place.
Good move underneath.
And a travel violation.
Yep. That was good defense that time by LaRochelle. Was it? Yeah, LaRochelle. She held her ground, and the Oyster River player had no idea she was there. Minnick with the ball. Over to LaRochelle. With the ball is Gagnon. Three shot.
Oh. Good shot by Durham. Right in the defender's face.
Great shot. Nice corner.
On the other end, no good.
And a rebound that time by LaRochelle. And again, looking. Good dribble. Oh, nice give and go. Lost control of the ball. Gilmore had it. She took her eye off the ball and went out of bounds. It'll be Oyster River ball.
Looks like Sir Royce will be checking in for the first time, junior.
Full court pressure, man and man.
Like a flash, but too much muster, out of bounds.
She beat her man, and she couldn't get it down there. It got it up too high. Dominic will control the ball for Goffstown. Ooh.
Almost picked off.
Long pass. And that's what they were looking for.
Good defense.
Oh, that foul's going to be on Minnick. That'll be her first. That'll be the team's fifth. And going to the line for Oyster River is Broussard. She'll be shooting two. First one's good. And her second. And that one's good.
First 2 points of the second quarter for Oyster River.
Oh, tried to force. Saroy tried to force that one in, and Oyster River picked it up. Good job that time by Durham. She gets it ahead to Minnick. She stops on the sideline, needs some help.
She gets it.
Durham tries to get it back inside. We get a foul on Oyster River.
Good play by Durham.
Yep. That'll be on Broussard. That'll be her first.
Looks like Welsh, Brennan are checking back in, and McBride will be checking in for the first time, too. Another senior.
McBride with the ball. Brennan on the point. Looking to drive, she does. Goes all the way through, and she's fouled.
Good take by Brennan.
Yep, she's fouled by Lipinski. That'll be her first. That's a team seventh.
I've noticed with both Welsh and Brennan, they're both taking it to the hole every time they get the ball. They're not getting lazy and trying to take too many outside shots.
Well, they're playing. As they spread the floor a bit, it opens up that middle. So. What's happening is the first one's good for Brennan. The defense collapses, and they're reaching in, so yeah. They're fouling the person.
Already shows the maturity that Brennan and Walsh are already having. They're not trying to act all cocky. Like, I've seen so many freshmen on varsity in the boys' league try to act all cocky, try to carry the team. But
yep, the second one is good. The 15-8, full court pressure by Goffstown, man-to-man. Switch off with a kick. Good defense that time by Walsh. Oh, nice play by Brennan.
Good play by Brennan. Clean steal, but.
Still Oyster River's ball. Trying to look inside, get it over in the middle. Good defense by Goffstown.
Almost a backcourt right there.
Yep. Outside shot is good by Durant. I think that's the first one from the outside they've put in.
Yep.
Okay, again, Oyster River stays man to man. Good ball movement.
Good play by Walsh.
Brennan with the three-point shot is good.
What a shot by Brennan. Good play by both the freshmen.
Nice give it go.
Walsh trying to draw attention, and Brennan completely losing her defender.
Well, that time Gilmore fouled. Going to the line for Oyster River is going to be Sprague. She'll be shooting two. And we've got a timeout, 30-second timeout. Did you notice who called the timeout?
I think it was Goffstown.
So Goffstown leads 18-10 here in the second quarter with 4 minutes to go, and going to the line for two is Gabby Sprang for Oyster River. She takes her first shot. And that one's good. And she gets a second.
Oyster River doing a good job hitting their free throws.
Yep. They're perfect at the line so far. Until I just jinxed them.
Nothing wrong for us.
That's right. Running with it. She gets it over to Saroy. She lost control. Oyster River picks it up.
Try to get a little too fancy.
Yeah.
Almost lost it right there.
Oh, smart move by Oyster River. Got trapped in the corner and bounced it off of Walsh's leg. Oyster River has the ball underneath. Get it outside. Trying to drive to the hoop. Nothing there. Looking inside, shot up, and good. That was by Craig. That's her first basket of the game. Hey, again, Brennan with Gilmore. Gilmore driving into the paint, all the way up, no good.
Too strong.
Right idea. Oyster River looking to drive. Kicks it back outside. Outside shot that time by Spring.
Leads down to three.
Now it's 18-15. Just under 3 minutes to go here in the second quarter. The ball is McBride. She gets it over to Gilmore, back to McBride.
Oh, nice play by Walsh.
Oh, nice play.
Oh, she traveled.
Wow.
I saw a foul right there. I didn't see a travel.
Yeah. In the game for Goffstown is Britton Doucette
and Perez.
Okay, again, full court pressure. And
ball's loose.
Picked up by Goffstown. McBride. Oh, she thought she had Perez in the middle, and Perez didn't stay in the paint. Ball knocked out of bounds by Goffstown. By McBride. It'll be Oyster River's ball.
Almost lost it right there.
Good give and go that time.
Oh, rims out.
Rebound. Nice rebound that time by Perez. Brennan gets it ahead over to McBride. McBride driving to the basket.
Take it in.
Nice play.
Good play by McBride.
Oyster River driving.
Like a flash on the other end.
In the paint. Oyster River takes a shot. Whoa.
Turnaround Jay's good.
Basket by Lewis. 20-17. 1:40 to go here in the second quarter. Brennan Saroy takes the drive to the hoop. All the way in. Nice job.
Good play by the sophomore.
That was Perez, right?
Yep, that was.
Yeah, my mistake. Shot outside. No good. Rebound taken underneath by Goffstown.
Looks like the pace is starting to pick up a little bit. Here's Walsh.
Kicks it outside. Three-point shot. No good. Nice basket. Nice rebound by Walsh. Oh, in and out. Saved by Oyster River. 1 minute to go here in the second quarter.
Lewis definitely has some speed to herself.
Boy, she's a lot of pressure. Oh, she had her. She was putting the pressure on and then got a little push.
Yeah, McBride clobbered her. 1-1 for Oyster River.
That's her first and team seventh, so be 1-1. Going to the line for us to River is Lewis. First shot is up and no good. Rebound fought for underneath. Picked up by Goffstown. Brennan loses control.
There she goes on the ground again.
She's hustling.
Doesn't get rewarded for the ball though.
Yep. 51 seconds left. Oyster River inbounds the ball on the side. Looking to try to get it in the paint. Good defense by Goffstown, keeping them out. Shot taken underneath. That time by Durant. 22-19. Brennan with the ball. Driving the ball to the basket was Perez. The shot was no good. Rebound Oyster River. Bring it all the way down. Nice give and go. Into the middle. No good. Rebound that time by McBride. Picked up by Brennan. Oh, she tried to get it ahead to Walsh. And Oyster River picks up the ball.
Down to 7 seconds left.
Three-point shot from the outside, no good.
Line drive,
rebound
no good.
Rebound underneath by McBride. Brennan with the ball.
Oh!
Shot, no good.
Way off.
So at half, we are at Goffstown 22, Oyster River 19. For Oyster River, they have Broussard has two. Durant has one. Broussard one. Chambers has two. And Lipinski has one. So two of their starters have two fouls apiece. And again, like I said, Goffstown is not in any foul trouble at all at this point in time. Both teams have been playing full court man to man. So,
yeah. So I just want to give a quick shout out to all the fans who came here tonight. Specifically, I was asked by Ryan Hall and Joy Poisson to give me a shout out. So, shout out to you boys, everybody else who came tonight. It's a great crowd we have here tonight.
Yeah, better than the first time we came out. So Goffstown has the ball first here in the second half. And Brennan gets it over to Walsh.
It's like Walsh's going to drive.
Another drive to the basket. That's her third one tonight. Oyster River pushes the ball back up court. Ooh, that should have been a travel. Shot that time is good. That was by Lewis.
Goes Walsh like a flash on the other end.
And she's fouled. We're going to be shooting two.
I don't mind saying the freshman's certainly not playing like a freshman. She's playing like a junior or senior.
So that foul's on Lewis. That's her first and team. That's her first and team's first. First one's good. Second one is good. So Goffstown ahead, 26-21. Oyster River with the ball. Looking to drive. Kicked it outside, back inside again.
Good defense by Edmonds.
Oh, nice job that time. Running right in front of her and it deflected off an Oyster River player and out of bounds.
Let's see if Goffstown can get on a run here, try to start building a good lead.
Here, Brennan on the point. Again, looking, trying to get inside to three-point shot for Goffstown. No good. Rebound fought for underneath and knocked out of bounds by Goffstown. That was Britton Doucette that tried that three. Oyster River with the ball. Goffstown remains man to man. Good pickup underneath to stop the drive by Goffstown. Oyster River tries to get the ball inside. They do. They kick it back outside, but too high.
Another mistake by Oyster River.
You know, when you have the lane, you should take it. You shouldn't be passing back out.
Exactly.
I mean, if you're dealing with Twin Towers or something underneath, that's a different story, but height-wise, they were about the same. So Brennan with the ball with Goffstown. Looking, she's trying to get inside to Edmonds. And again, Saroy Perez. There goes Edmonds now. No good. Rebound by Oyster River. They push it up the court quickly. Back in the middle. Shot up. Bank shot that time by Durant.
Good shot.
26-23. Goffstown with a three-point lead. Perez takes a three-point shot.
Good shot.
Oh, yes.
Another good three-pointer by another sophomore.
Excellent. Caught in the middle, and again, Durant. Oyster River is trying to look. Good doubling up underneath by Goffstown, forcing Oyster River to find a person outside, and we're going to have a foul this time. Foul is on. Looks like it's going to be on Sprague.
Oh, I thought that was a foul on Welsh.
Nope.
Well, in that case, good play by Welsh.
That's her first. So Edmonds inbounds the ball to Brennan. Brennan looking, trying to get it inside to Edmonds.
Nice crossover.
Good, nice job that
good
time.
Good play.
That was set up that time by Edmonds. She pulled right out of the paint, opened up right up.
That's exactly what I said earlier, how both Welsh and Brennan were driving in.
Yep. Brennan with the rebound.
Fast break.
Looking ahead, gets it. Oh, nice
good
job.
Play.
Oh.
What a play by Walsh.
Great pass by Brennan.
And it's a 10-point lead. 10-point lead for Goffstown.
Off-balance shot. Back in the paint to Durant. She scores a basket for Oyster River. Brennan brings it up. Three-point shot from the outside. By Britton Drissett. Rebound Oyster River. To bring it up. Get it back inside.
Oh, got the steal.
Brennan. Whoa. And then Oyster River hustles back and knocks the ball out of bounds. It'll be Goffstown ball underneath.
And timeout Goffstown.
Yep.
So Goffstown coming out in a flash, already scoring 11 points in just the first few minutes.
Yeah, Kelly Walsh, she's on fire.
Yeah. How many points does she have?
She scored four in the first half, and she's got six this third quarter.
Wow.
She's got two baskets and two foul shots.
Great hustle by the freshman.
Oyster River is trying to get it to their center, Durant. She's been effective underneath. When she gets the ball, but we'll see what Goffstown. Brennan will take the ball out of bounds underneath the basket. She gets it in to Edmonds. Back in the corner to Brennan. She's looking to drive, no help. Gets it in the middle. Nice
give
and
go. Open shot, and it's good. The nice freshman
play.
Again.
What a give and go from Brennan to Walsh.
Those are just two players who just seem to always know how each other plays and where they always are.
Good job that time on defense for Goffstown, forcing the ball step on the line, and now Goffstown will take the ball up with a 10-point lead. Brennan with the ball on a point. Again, they're looking to do that same give and go inside, but Edmonds, ball's knocked out of bounds. Be Goffstown ball. Brennan has it. Looking. Nice job inside to Edmonds. And, yeah, she traveled. Good defense that time by Oyster River. Lewis brings the ball up for Oyster River. Good pick. She tries a drive.
Lob shot.
Way outside. Three-point shot that time by Durant. No good. Rebound taken by Brennan. She gets it ahead to Walsh.
Give it to guess who.
I think she was thinking she had the lane that time, and she lost control. In the game for Goffstown is Gagnon. She replaces Britton Doucette. Brennan with the ball, getting ready to inbound. She finds Edmonds. Walsh with it.
Oh, nice. Behind the back.
Nice play. I thought she would have hit for an offensive foul there for a second. Goffstown maintains the control of the ball. The ball, Walsh. Over to Perez, to Gagnon, back to Brennan. Brennan looking, again back, Gagnon, inside to Brennan. Brennan will take the drive, and she goes up, and she gets fouled. Brennan will go to the line for two.
Once again, the freshmen are coming in with big plays.
And that is on Broussard. That's her third. So Brennan will be going for two. That's Broussard's third, so. First shot's up, no good. And substitute for Oyster River.
Looks like it's Broussard, Abby Broussard.
Yep. Brennan for her second shot. That one's good.
11-point lead now for Goffstown.
Goffstown picking up at half court. Still man-to-man. Durant outside, three-point shot, no good. Rebound taken down by Perez. Gets it ahead to Walsh.
She going to drive.
Takes a three-point shot, and it's good.
From the parking lot. In a defender's face, she fired that from the parking lot.
Great shot.
And the steal.
Perez to the hoop.
And good. In.
Good heads-up play by Perez.
Wow. Goffstown starting to pull away from this.
Shot no good. Rebound fought for underneath with Edmonds. You got a jump ball. It's going to remain Oyster River ball.
Wow, that was a good shot by Walsh. So surprised she even took that, but that was a good shot. Fired up from the parking lot. And Goffstown's lead is coming.
Whoa, and it ball's out of bounds. So it'll be Goffstown ball. She hit the back of the backboard from underneath. Oyster River is not pressing full court. They're still in man-to-man. Goffstown leads 41-25 with 2:20 left here in the third quarter. The ball is Gagnon. She's got Perez. Perez, nice move.
Crossover.
Nice, gets her own rebound, goes up, and we're going to have a jump ball.
That'll be Goffstown ball.
It was a nice move. She faked a pass to the point and got the baseline, but wasn't able to finish, but the right idea. Oh, we got a five-second violation on inbounding the ball by Goffstown. So Oyster River takes over. Goffstown continues with full court pressure. And that's Durant. Scores a basket for Oyster River.
Right idea by Gilmore, though. She didn't leave her defender. She tried to cut it off, though, but it was just a perfect pass.
Yep.
Another three.
Perez.
Oh. Again. Perez is hot.
She's feeling it. Full court pressure.
The threes have been flying this quarter.
Oh, nice. Oh, I thought we had a block that time.
You can tell the fans don't like that at all.
He called that one on.
Called that on Gilmore.
Gilmore. That's her second. And going to line for Oyster River is Annie Lewis. for two. First one's good.
Looks like Durham and LaRochelle will be checking back in.
The one shot left here for Lewis. First shot, the second one is good. Brennan brings it up. She gets it outside to Gilmore. And we have a foul in Oyster River. Or is it on Goffstown?
Looks like it was on Goffstown.
Who was that on 30? That was on Durham. Full court pressure continues. Gilmore, nice job that time.
Got sloppy with the ball.
She reached in, touched the ball, and went right off the Oyster River player and out of bounds. Walsh will put it in.
Pass in to LaRochelle.
LaRochelle with the ball. Gilmore. Minnick with it, gets it over to Gilmore. Oh, LaRochelle. Now over to, that was LaRochelle, sorry. Gilmore with it. Over to Durham.
Minnick for three,
it's good! Minnick joins the three-point club again.
The threes continue to fly this quarter.
She's got two. Shot that time by Broussard for Oyster River, Abby Broussard, that's for two.
That was up fake.
Oh, we got a jump ball.
They all fall down again.
Goffstown full court pressure. Inbounded. Oyster River Durant with the ball.
LaRochelle's getting very physical on defense with her, trying to deny her the ball. And
she fouled her. That'll be her second. Team's third. Taking the ball out on the side. Oyster River. And we're going to have a backcourt violation.
10 seconds left. See if Goffstown will try to hold for three, try to get the lead back up to 19.
Hey, Walsh has got it on the point. Goes, she's going to drive all the way. No good.
Try to
rebound,
get to contact.
Oyster River. Quick outlet pass all the way down court, and the basket is good. They beat the buzzer for Sprague. Picks up the two. So at the end of three, Goffstown 47 and Oyster River 31. Well, we saw some 4 three-point shots in that period.
Wow.
By Goffstown.
It seems like whatever their coach talked about in the locker room during halftime, it's working out.
They did a nice job.
Yeah. Though Oyster River did a good job too. They scored 14 in the third quarter as well. So both sides having a very good offensive game though, but it's Goffstown.
So Goffstown picked up 25 points in that period.
They scored more points this quarter than in the first half.
And Oyster River had 14 in that period. Yeah, because they scored 22 in the first half.
Yeah.
So that was a great breakout. Their man-to-man is working very well.
Yep.
And when they get beat, they're getting picked up. Other players are picking up the the B players. So
looks like Brenton Doucette, McBride, Edmonds, and Mr. Royce are back in for the Grizzlies.
So Brenton with the ball on the point. McBride, Saroy. She gets it over to Edmonds. Oh, nice give and go.
Nice play.
And we're going to have a foul on Oyster River.
Once again, the freshmen are taking it to the hole, getting fouled.
You know, when you start playing together at that age as a freshman and sophomores, you're going to good promises for the future. Mm. So Brennan going to the line. She'll shoot two. First one is no good. And she'll get a second. And that one's good. 48-33, Goffstown leads here in the fourth quarter. Again, Goffstown stays. Goffstown looks like it's gone to a 2-3 zone.
Shot's way off.
Oh, ball just went right through the middle. No one touched it. It'll be Goffstown ball underneath. Edmonds gets it into Brennan. Saroy, Edmonds, drives, stops, kicks it back outside. McBride. Oh, nice job that time. Brennan takes the three.
Another three.
Oh, it's out of bounds.
Ah.
Hit the front of the rim and up off the back. Thought we had another one there. Oyster River with the ball. Three-point shot by Durant.
Line drive shots off the mark.
Driving to the basket underneath, and we're going to have a blocking foul. Looks like it's going to be on Edmonds. Yep. We got a blocking foul on Edmonds. That's her second. And the team's fourth. Oyster River inbounds the ball. Again, a zone. Whoa, that time we're going to have a foul on Goffstown on McBride.
Looks like Brennan was a little frustrated because of that.
That's her second. Team's fifth. Three-point shot by Oyster River. No good. Rebound taken underneath by Minnick. Gets it ahead to Brennan. Brennan looks to drive. Kicks it back outside to McBride. Again, Brennan controls the top. Over to Saroy. Cross court. To Brenton Doucette. Brennan drives to the basket. Takes the shot up. No good, but we're going to have a foul. Shooting two.
Seems like Brennan's always... Brennan and Welsh, they just use their smaller height to their advantage as they're a lot quicker.
Yeah, they got the speed driving to that hoop. And that foul is on Natalie Durant. That's her second.
It's like Durham will be checking back in.
And the first one is good. Durham in for McBride. And Brennan will take her second shot. That's good. And that gives Goffstown a 50-33 lead. Just under 6 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. Oyster River looking to try to penetrate the zone. They do get it in, but then it's knocked. Oh. Good hustle by Brennan that time. Get knocked out of bounds. Goffstown denying the inbound pass to the paint. I think Goffstown's going to try to force them to go outside.
It seems like Oyster River starting to realize they need to start taking outside shots to get back in the game, but they're not falling right now.
Well, Goffstown's playing that 2-3 zone, so it's going to force them to go out.
Yeah. Very smart move by their coach to make them go to a 2-3. Try to slow things down.
Well, if they try to drive against a zone, they're going to get trapped.
Yeah.
So shot up. No. Ooh. And we're going to have a foul on Brennan.
It was a little questionable right there.
Yeah, I didn't think that. I thought she had hit the ball.
It's like three free throws. Or is it two?
Two.
Foot was on the line probably.
Going to the line is Annie Lewis. First shot is up and it's good.
Minnick will be checking back in for the Grizzlies along with Sprang.
For Oyster River. Lewis with her second shot. It's an unusual stance. No good. Rebound fought for underneath, taken by Goffstown. Minnick. And we're going to have a jump ball.
Jump ball.
It's going to go to Oyster River. They take it out underneath. Getting Goffstown with the zone. Not allowing them to penetrate. Keeping the ball outside. Now they finally get it into paint. And we're going to have a foul. Looks like it's either going to be on Minnick or Edmonds.
Yeah, it looks like she got clobbered right there.
Yep, it's going to be on Edmonds, and that's going to be her third. Possession foul, so it's taken out underneath by Oyster River. Shot attempt by Oyster River outside, no good. Rebound by Broussard, Abby Broussard. She gets it, drives baseline, no good. Rebound taken underneath by Oyster River. Back outside, rebound fought for underneath and picked up by Durham. She gets it ahead to Minnick. Saroy to Minnick. And
three-pointer off the mark.
No good. That was Britton Doucette that attempted that one. Oyster River trying to get in quickly.
Is Britton Doucette still trying to join the three-point club?
I think it is. Oh, nice steal that time.
Here comes Sarois. She traveled.
It's too bad she gave up the ball, because I think if she kept on going, she may have had the basket.
Yeah, she definitely could have.
She's not selfish. So Oyster River takes the ball out of bounds. And again, Goffstown. I'm not quite sure what they're playing, if it's a box and one or. And we're going to have a foul underneath the basket. Looks like Durham with a hold. That's her second.
It's like one and one for Oyster River.
And going to the line is going to be Abby Broussard. First shot's up, no good. Rebound taken.
Short.
By Saroy.
Comes to Minnick.
Minnick lost control of the ball and ended up in a jump. Goffstown maintains position.
On the ground they go again.
Sweeping the floor. Minnick. The ball inside to LaRochelle. Driving their basket is Durham. Inside LaRochelle. Takes a shot.
She gets fouled.
She'll be going to the line for two. And the foul is on Natalie Durant. That's her third. Shooting two is LaRochelle. First one's no good. Entering the game for Goffstown is Kelly Walsh.
The freshman.
She replaces
Sarois.
Sarois. And the second one's no good. Rebound is taken by Oyster River. Shot taken outside.
Long two.
That time by Sprang. A banker. The ball is Minnick, gets it inside Edmonds. Tries to drive, lost control of the ball. Oyster River picks it up. Going full court, nice give and go that time by Oyster River. Spraying over to Sophie Brassard.
Looks like Goffstown's defense has sort of slowed down this quarter now.
That foul is on Walsh. That's her first. And to the line for Oyster River is Sophie Brassard. Missed the first one. She takes a second. No good. Rebound taken underneath by Oyster River. Goffstown looks like it's gone out to man-to-man again. Shot taken, no good. Rebound fought for underneath, taken that time by Oyster River. Lewis picks up the loose ball and puts it in. 50-38.
Closing the gap.
Three-point shot taken outside by Walsh.
Put it back.
Okay, so Walsh has got the ball on the point. Three-point shot taken by Lara Shelvin. Blocked. Oyster River coming back down court. Oh, I think we're going to have a travel.
Yep, she traveled. Gilmore checking back in for Edmonds.
Just under 3 minutes to go. Goffstown leads here in the fourth quarter, 50-38. Minnick with the ball on the point. Over to Gilmore. Over to Larichelle. Oh, that's Walsh.
And Walsh again.
Again for the drive.
Doing that all night, and she's been scoring all the time.
Three-point shot for Oyster River, in and out. Rebound fought for, taken by Oyster River.
Thought about
Brassard
the three.
Brassard goes for the hoop, gets it. That's for Abby Brassard. Medic with the ball, and we got a timeout, Goffstown. Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a full timeout.
Been a good game tonight.
Now, Goffstown's only had one basket here in the fourth quarter, but they've had three foul shots.
Yeah.
And then Oyster River has picked up 6 points off the floor and then one foul shot. And it's 52-40 here in the fourth quarter.
It's about that time the Oyster River realizes that it's go time. They need to score.
Yeah. And Goffstown switched from their 2-3 zone and went back to man-to-man. Next game for the girls is going to be on Friday night here in the Grizzly Den.
What was it, Friday, you said?
Yeah, Friday. I'm not,
playing Laconia.
Is it Laconia they're playing?
Yep.
So Goffstown will get the ball after their timeout. Walsh will inbound the ball. She gets it into Minnick in the backcourt. And he brings it up over half court. Oyster River has gone man to man now. Trying to force.
Let's go, Goffstown!
Goffstown's going to look at, just going to play perimeter basketball. Minnick with a 3-point shot.
The parking lot scores Goffstown.
Great shot. 55-40, and we got a kick on Walsh. It'll be Oyster River's ball. Switched. Oyster River gets the ball in. Goffstown now in a 2-3 zone. Shot taken outside. Rebound fought for underneath and taken by Durham. Gets it ahead to Minnick. She's driving up court. Gets it over to Walsh. She takes
Walsh for three.
In and out. Fought for underneath and lost control of the ball.
Hit the deck.
Goffstown picks it up. Walsh with it again, looking to drive. She drives again.
Again.
Another basket for Walsh. She uses her right hand and left hand on her drives, yeah, depending on the side she's on.
Yeah, it looks like she's ambidextrous.
Three-point shot by Oyster River, way off the mark. Picked up by Durham. Minnick with it. She bringing it up court. She's being pressured by Oyster River. Walsh with it. And we got another timeout by Goffstown.
It's like a full timeout.
Yep. Coach wants to get the rest, to make sure the rest of the players are in. Everybody get a chance on that ball.
Looks like Fliegel will be checking in.
That's the first time she's been in tonight. And we're going without the okay, so under a minute. On the point with the ball, Perez tried to get it inside to Gilmore, but it was picked off by Oyster River. They're driving, bringing it down court. Shot taken outside. It's a two-point shot. No good. Rebound taken by Oyster River. Shot from the foul line. No good. Oyster River fighting for the ball, and it goes out of bounds on them. It'll be Goffstown ball. Goffstown. Perez brings it up. Perez looking. Oh, we're going to have a foul on
yep.
Broussard.
She got fouled right there.
Yep. That's her second, I believe. Oh, that was on, they called that one on Durant. I'm sorry. That's her fourth. So Perez goes to the line. First one is no good. Rebound taken by Oyster River. Oh, we're gonna have an offense. We're gonna have an offensive foul. I think we do. Yep, it's an offensive foul. She was swinging those elbows and she caught the player in the hit in the chest.
It's very dangerous.
Yep. And so that's her fifth foul and she's out of the game. With 21 seconds left here in the fourth quarter, Goffstown inbounds the ball underneath the basket. Gets it back outside.
It's like Goffstown will just run out the clock.
Gilmore with it. Look for some help. And she's fouled that time by Sophie Broussard.
Fliegel will go to the free throw line.
Yep, that'll be, that's her fourth. And going to the line for Goffstown. Abby Fliegel. First shot up, no good. Rebound underneath by Gagnon. And she's fouled. That foul was on Sprague. First shot up, no good. Rebound taken by Oyster River, but it's a two-shot foul.
Looks like they didn't know that.
Yep. Well, I guess sometimes better be safe than sorry.
Yeah.
And her second shot. No good, didn't hit anything, so it's going to be Oyster River ball underneath the basket. With 6 seconds to go, Goffstown just sits back. Ball's inbounded by Oyster River.
Be another good win for Goffstown tonight. Make that four in a row.
Four in a row.
Shots
by
no
Oyster
good.
River, no good. And the final score is 57-40, Goffstown.